I want to talk to you about different types of environmental audits that you're most likely going to encounter at one point in your business. So if you want to know what these audits are, keep on watching. Now, we are going to talk about three main types of environmental audits. There are so many other environmental audits because, as you know, the environment is very diverse. We could talk about different audits, but in this case, we're going to talk about three of them that are really, really, really common. And the first one that we're going to talk about is a control audit. Now, this is an audit that is usually done by the environmental inspectors from NEMA. So this one is done specifically by the environmental inspectors. So they're going to come to your facility and they're going to check at how you are complying to the environmental laws and regulations. So this one is done randomly. Anytime the authority, that is NEMA, deems it right to come to your facility and do an environmental audit, then they're going to come and do a control audit. Now, of course, this one mainly will happen after your facility has had issues, like, for example, there is suspicion of maybe pollution, or there's an issue with your facility or your business. That is most probably when it is going to happen, but in most cases it does not really happen. But it could happen, and this is where now the NEMA officers themselves, the environmental inspectors from NEMA, will come to your facility and do an audit themselves to see how compliant you are. The second type of environmental audit is an initial environmental audit. Now, listen and listen very carefully. An initial environmental audit is supposed to be done to projects that are ongoing that were implemented before EMCA. And that means EMCA is the Environmental Act that gives a mandate, provision of NEMA, and gives mandate to NEMA to go ahead with its operations. So if your facility or your building or your business came into action or started operating before 1999, then probably you are exempted from carrying out an environmental impact assessment, and you are required to carry out an initial audit. So an initial audit is done for projects that did not do an environmental impact assessment, because by then NEMA had not been formed. And that means if your project has been done or came to operational after that, if you did a petrol station after 1999, then you are supposed to have done an EIA and not an initial audit. So that one is very important to understand. Like, you could go to schools that were done long time ago, 1990s, 1980s, those ones we are supposed to do an initial environmental audit. So this initial environmental audit is a very comprehensive audit that checks to establish a baseline status of the facility. And then in future, any other audit that will be done will be based on the initial audit. Third type of audit that is usually done every now and then is an annual audit. This one is done annually, like the name suggests. And this one is done to projects that have already done an environmental impact assessment and have gotten their license, and those projects that were supposed to do an initial audit. So these two that did this then are supposed to conduct an annual audit, done annually. And this one is done either by an environmental expert in most cases, but if you're compliant, then with time you can start doing a self-audit. So these annual audits are self-audits that you have to do it to your facility. If you're having a petrol station, a school, a residential building, any project that you have that has an environmental impact assessment license requires to do an annual audit. And these annual audit checks to see that you are conforming and you are carrying your activities according to the conditions given in the environmental impact assessment license. So these are the three type of audits that we have. A control audit done by the environmental inspectors from NEMA. We have the initial environmental audits. These ones are specifically done by environmental experts who are qualified and licensed. And we have the annual audits / self-audits, which after you are compliant, then you can be given a go-ahead to carry out self-audits once in a while. But after some time, you need to keep involving an expert for the sake of objectivity in your audit. So those are the three main type of audits that you're going to encounter in your life. If your project has an EIA, then most probably what you need to do is annual audits every other year. So as you're planning for your financial budget, make sure to consider environmental audits as part of your annual activity. Make sure to watch these two videos that I'm going to link somewhere up here. Until next time, keep safe and God bless you.